Hi class 6, welcome to the physics class once again. So today we are going to start the exercise for revision in the page number 29. So please take out. So here what we are going to do, this exercise for revision is related to the topic what we have just now covered, that is measurement of time. Okay, so let's get started with number 8. Number 1 says the SI unit of time is what? So here we know that SI unit of time is second. So correct option is option D. Number 2, how many minutes are there in a day? Now for that we need to know what? First of all, how many minutes are in a hour? And in a day, how many hours are there? So one day is equals to 24 hours, right? We know that. So 24 hour, and in 1 hour how many minutes are there? 60 minutes. So if 1 hour contains 60 minutes, so 24 hour contain how many minutes? 24 into 60. Now after you multiply that, you will get a number of 1440. So that is the right answer. That is option number B. Okay. Coming to the number 3, which of the following is not used for measuring time? Now among these 4 options, one will be incorrect and we have to find that. So first one is mechanical stopwatch, B electronic stopwatch, C pendulum clock, D electronic balance. Now the right option for this question is electronic balance, because with the help of balance what we measure the mass. Come to the number B, fill in the blanks. Number 1 says dash is the interval between two events. Options are given time and distance. So what is that? Dash is the interval between two events. So between two events when we are measuring, that is the time. Okay. Number 2, a dash works on the principle of a simple pendulum. Now who works? Pendulum clock. We have already read about that. Number 3, a dash is used to measure short interval of time. Now which kind of device is used to measure short interval of time? What we have already known, that what kind of devices are used by the athletes when they are doing some activity or exercises, that is the right is stopwatch. Okay, so these are all for today, and with these I have attached a question answer that are related with the part 9, 10 and 11. That is related, those parts which are related to the measurement of time. So please take that attachment and solve it. So we are going to see each other in the next video. So thank you for watching.